open up the eyes of our heart. Push away all distractions. That we would see you in your beauty and in your glory this morning. Take us beyond the veil. Would you take us beyond the veil? To see what elders see. What do they see that makes them cry? Holy, holy, holy. What are they lost in that they cry? Holy, holy, holy. could see you, God. Surrounded in beauty, surrounded in glory and splendor. Sea of glass around your throne, lightnings and thunderings coming from the throne. And wave after wave of glory, wave after wave of glory. Wave after wave of glory. Surrounding the one who is worthy. Surrounding the one who is worthy. Changes everything. This changes everything. After this, I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven. The first voice which I had heard speaking to me like a trumpet said, "Come up here, and I will show you what must take place after this." Once I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne stood in heaven. With one seated on the throne. And he was sat there, had the appearance of jasper and carnelian, and all around the throne was a rainbow that had the appearance of an emerald. And around the throne were 24 thrones. And seated on the throne were 24 elders clothed in white garments with golden crowns on their heads. From the throne came flashes of lightning and rumblings and peals of thunder. And before the throne were burning seven torches of fire, which are the seven spirits of God. And before the throne there was, as it were, a sea of glass like crystal. And all around the throne, on each side of the throne, are four living creatures full of eyes in front and behind. The first living creature like a lion, the second living creature like an ox, the third living creature with the face of a man, and the fourth living creature like an eagle in flight. And the four living creatures, each of them with six wings, are full of eyes all around and within. And day and night they never cease to say, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." And whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to Him who is seated on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before Him who is seated on the throne and worship Him who lives forever and ever. They cast their crowns before the throne, saying, "Worthy are You, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power, for You created all things. By Your will they existed and were created." We join in with the elders around Your throne. Cast our crowns before their crowns before the One who is, the One who was, the One who is to come. Let her cast her crowns before the One who was and is and is.
Staring at the beauty of our King.
storms of life. Far above all the storms of life, the storms of life. Oh, there is a throne.
Crown and praises, there is a throne. Thank you.
deserving of glory. Fully deserving, fully deserving all the glory.
A thousand generations, you are. Praise is yours.
sing of your beauty, cause with every breath you give, we will sing of your praise, sing of your beauty. We were made for this.
Speed.
stirring deep inside. You're all that really satisfies. We worship you. Passion stirring deep inside. A passion stirring deep inside. You're all that really satisfies. We worship.
Expressions of your love on the earth. Lord, thank you for this time where we can gaze upon you, where we can fix our eyes on you, the only worthy one, the only one worth beholding, the only one worth becoming like. God, we thank you that it's as simple as that, that when we behold you, we're transformed into the likeness of Jesus. And God, we earnestly ask you to bring us revelation. Revelation of your nature, of your character, of your goodness, your kindness, your gentleness, your faithfulness. That you would give us revelation, that you would open our eyes, that you would soften our hearts to receive everything, Lord, that you have for us. Lord, the places that we've closed ourselves off, where we've been blind, where we've been deaf, where where we've deafened ourselves so that we can't hear your voice, that we can't receive your love, God, I pray that you would soften us, God, that we'd be able to see you and hear you in the fullness of your glory, in every way that we were made to, God. Lord, I ask for fresh grace, God, to understand, to see, to behold, and to become. Lord, this is our declaration that we love you, that we want to gaze upon you, that we want to become like you. But God, we are weak, and our flesh, Lord, is weak, but Lord, you are strong. Your spirit within us is strong. So we ask, God, that you will come, that your spirit will overtake us and overwhelm us, God, that you will teach us. Make us more like you, Jesus.
Originally designed family to be, God. We prophesy that revelation is going
brought into a cruel world, but Lord, rather that they would be seen as a blessing, a source of life, an agent of great change, God, we pray that you would impart your eyes for parents to see their children, to see their families from heaven's perspective. God, we declare blessing and we release destiny right now over the current generations and the generations to come, that world changers, atmosphere shifters, worshipers, influential leaders are being born and raised up as we speak. We speak forth faith to believe that children will flourish, that they will receive much, that they will give much throughout their lives, God. We pray that you would give vision to parents and to families, that even before the birth of their child, even in the naming of their child, that there would be destiny and prophetic meaning that's spoken, God. We pray, Lord, that the unique form, the unique personality and giftings of each person and child will be celebrated. God, we ask for blessing and vision that you would breathe purpose into the households of North Korea. And God, that there would be hope that the current state that they're in is not dictating. Lord, their circumstances are not dictating their hope and their vision, but that your goodness and that your revelation instead is the source of their hope, God.
Thank you.
those who have never known, who've never seen, who've never experienced it. Lord God, we lift up all fathers and father figures in North Korea. We speak courage right now over them. Lord God, we come against any demonic agenda to emasculate, to oppress, distract, or deafen the ears of the fathers in North Korea. And Lord, we instead declare righteousness, boldness, integrity, and the protective, loving heart of our Heavenly Father to be imparted upon them. Believing that with each passing week and month and year, God, you're binding. ask for greater revelation. You designed your story around family, and it's written all across your word in every promise, God. And we believe that you desire to give us, to give North Korea, greater revelation of family. We ask your longing for family, your vision, your standards, your love to be conveyed to the precious people of North Korea. And we pray that one day we can meet them and hear them testify of how the spirit of adoption and the love of their Heavenly Father has transformed their lives and resurrected them from the dead. And we pray that you continue to reveal to us your heart, God. Be glorified in and through every expression of family here on this peninsula. Come and be our Father. Come and be our Redeemer. We pray this in Jesus' name.
Joining us this morning. We hope that you are blessed to start out your day in God's presence. The rest of this month, we'll continue to meditate on Revelation 4. We hope that God continues to just peel back layers of revelation and give us even more of Himself as we seek Him earnestly. We hope that you are blessed, and we'll see you once again next week. We also have a Thursday night watch at 8 p.m. Otherwise, we'll see you next week. Have a wonderful rest of the day. It is super cold out there, so please stay warm and stay healthy. See you next time.